And now for something completely different.
Today saw the appointment of a new head.
Don't
of...
I say no more?
No fear. Today saw the appointment of a new head of Allied Bomber Command. Air Chief Marshal Sir Vincent Kill the Japs Forster. He's in our Birmingham studio.
Hello, sailors! Listen, guess what? The Ministerette of Aviation has made me head of the RAF Ola Pola.
Hello, Mrs. Rogers? No? Oh, I must be in the wrong house.
Morning, Mrs. G. Crump.
No, Mrs. G. Pinnett.
Well, it says Crump here, done it, Harry.
Yeah, it's on the invoice.
Yeah, it's definitely Crump.
Mr. Pudian, the very real problem is one of money. I'm afraid that the Ministry of Finance is no longer getting the kind of support that it needs. You see, there's defence, social security, health, housing, education, city wars. Mrs. Two Lumps, would you bring us in two coffees, please?
Yes, Mr. Teabag.
Out of a mind. Ah, here's the coffee.
Je vous présente, encore une fois, mon ami, le pouf célèbre, Jean Brian, Jean Petit.
Oh, merci, mon petit chouchou. Voyons, toi, Jean. Et maintenant?
Tuesday, a reign of terror was ended when the notorious Piranha brothers, Doug and Dinsdale, after one of the most extraordinary trials in British legal history, were sentenced to 400 years imprisonment for crimes of violence. Their father, Arthur Piranha, a scrap metal dealer and TV quizmaster, was well known to the police and a devout Catholic. In January 1928, he had married Kitty Malone, an up-and-coming East End boxer. Their next-door neighbour was Mrs. April Simnel.
Kipling Road were a typical sort of East End street.
Anthony Viney.
Doug and Dinsdale Piranha now formed a gang, which they called The Gang.
A small-time operator who fell foul of Dinsdale Piranha was Vince Snetterton Lewis.
Well, one day I was sitting at home, threatening the kids.
Another man who had his head nailed to the floor was Stig O'Tracy.
Stig, I've been told that Dinsdale Piranha nailed your head to the floor.
No! No, never! Never!
I understand he also nailed your wife's head to a coffee table. Isn't that right, Mrs. O'Tracy?
Oh, no!
Yeah, well, he did do that, yeah. Yeah. He was a cruel man, but fair.
Except inasmuch as he was convinced that he was being watched by a giant hedgehog, he referred to as Spiny Norman.
How big was Norman supposed to be?
Normally he was wont to be about 12 feet from snout to tail, but when Dinsdale was very depressed, Norman could be anything up to 800 yards long.
Dinsdale! Dinsdale!
Dinsdale was a gentleman. What's more, he knew how to treat a female impersonator.
Most of these strange tales concern Dinsdale, but what of Doug? One man who met him was Luigi Fercotti.
Well, I've been running a successful escort agency. High class. No, really, high class girls. We didn't have any of that. That was right out.
Hearing they'd gone back to London, I assumed the identity of a pork butcher, Brian Stokes. On my arrival in London, I discovered they had returned to Cardiff. I followed as Gloucester from King Lear. Acting on a hunch, I spent several months in Buenos Aires as Blind Pew, returning through the Panama Canal as Ratty in Toad of Toad Hall. Back in Cardiff, I relived my triumph as Sancho Panza in Men of La Mancha.
Those flowers are for Sergeant Lauderdale from the gentleman waiting outside.
Oh, good. Here we go then, Hawkins.
Oh, mad superintendent.
Good luck then.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
Bravo, Madge. Well done. Taxation is indeed the very nub of my gist, gentlemen.
This is Uncle Ted in front of the house.
In the early years of the 16th century, to combat the rising tide of religious unorthodoxy, the Pope gave Cardinal Jimenez of Spain...
Stop, stop, stop there, stop there, stop. A cheap weapon is a prize. Blah, 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 blah. Biggles. Bench. Bench. The cushions. Here we are, Lord. It is made of harder stuff. Cardinal Fang. Fetch the comfy chair. The comfy chair?
Julius Caesar on an Aldous lamp.
Mr. Justice Kilbracken.
Exhibit A, my lord, Miss Rita Fang. An artist's model, a Swedish accordion teacher and cane chair sales lady, was found guilty under the Rude Behaviour Act in the accused's court.
Morning, Miss Wills.
Morning, love.
In here, please.
Oh, thank you. Oh, hello. I saw your advertisement for flying lessons, and I'd like to make an appointment.
Well, Mr. Lenham is on the phone at the moment, but I'm sure he won't mind if you go on in. Through here.
Thank you.
Ah, I won't be a moment. Make yourself at home.
Mr. Jigger, so you want to learn to fly?
Well, that's the great thing about these modern airliners. I mean, I can keep this plane flying with only the smallest movement. And Pancho here doesn't have to move at all.
Reflected in tarn and loft, form the breathtaking backdrop against which Ewan McTeagle writes such poems as Lend Us a Quid to the One woman who remembers McTeagle is a young friend, Lassie O'Shea.
Since then, McTeagle has developed and widened his literary scope. 3 years ago, he concerned himself with quite small sums, quick bits of ready cash, sixpences, shillings. Although his name was quite clearly given as McTeagle, he was throughout wearing the Cameron tartan.
Mrs. Ratbag, if you don't mind me saying so, you're badly in need of an expensive course of psychiatric treatment.
I would like to take this opportunity of complaining about the way in which these shows are continually portraying psychiatrists.
Will you take Mrs. Pym to see Dr. Cream, please?
Oh, certainly, Doctor. Walk this way, please.
Oh, if I could walk that way, I would...
Mrs. Pym to see you, Dr. Cream.
Ah, yes, I just want another 5 minutes with Audrey. Could you show Mrs. Pym into the waiting room, please?
Yes, Doctor.
All right, Audrey, when did you first start thinking you were...